he was a reader of newspapers, so he'd occasionally have songs about what was going on in the news. And the owner of the station really believed in the First Amendment. He thought everybody had a right to be heard from, so he let a communist have 15 minutes on the air every day. And Woody was allowed 15 minutes on the air every day. He got paid all of $1, but he mimeographed a little songbook, and he said, "I got my songs in this book. If you send me 25 cents, I'll send you a copy." So he made a little extra money by selling his 25-cent songbook. It was called On a Slow Train Through California, which was a takeoff. There was a book of jokes sold in the Midwest, On a Slow Train Through Arkansas. Anyway, one day he said to the communist commentator, whose name was Ed Robbins, he said, "Ed, do you ever listen to my program? I listen to yours." And Ed was a little apologetic. He said, "Well, Woody, I have to confess, I don't usually listen to country music, and you're on before me, and I usually just arrive in time for my program." And Woody says, "Well, you come early tomorrow and listen to my song. I think you'll be interested." And next day, Ed heard, "Mr. Tom Mooney is free. Mr. Tom Mooney is free. Done got a pardon from that old jailhouse warden, Governor Culbert L. Olson's decree." Well, after the program, Ed said, "Woody, that's a great song. Do you know, there's going to be a big mass meeting tonight. Tom Mooney's going to speak there. They'd love to hear your song. Would you come?" And then he had second thoughts. He says, "Well, Woody, it's a little left wing." And Woody said, "Left wing, chicken wing, don't bother me none. I've been in the red all my life." So he went with Ed to the rally. There were 1,000 people listening to speech after speech after speech after speech. And Woody fell asleep. Ed had to walk across the stage and shake him. "Woody, you're on." Woody shook his head, picked up his guitar, walked to the microphone, and he sung his song. He got a standing ovation. He had to sing the song twice. And Will Geer, this actor, was in the audience. He goes up to Woody after the program. He said, "Woody, I'm going up tomorrow to put on a program for the striking workers in the lettuce fields up near Bakersfield. Would you come with me? They're mostly Okies like you. They'd love your songs." So pretty soon, Will and Woody were a team. And they sang at fundraising parties in Hollywood as well as up in the lettuce fields and so on. That's when Woody made up more songs like, "If you ain't got the do-re-mi, boy, better go back to beautiful Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, Georgia, Tennessee."